There's a growing strain on Kansas City firefighters. A mother and her children escaped these flames last night. Now, the concern is that the fire spread from a vacant house. KMBC 9's Diane Cho is joining us live. And Diane, talk to the fire chief about how these fires are affecting all of us.
There is extensive damage here to these homes caused by this fire last night, spreading into three other homes nearby. And the fire chief tells us they have responded to a large number of vacant house fires lately, especially here in Kansas City's east side. And in most cases that we've seen, firefighters have been able to put them out quickly. But as we saw last night, those fires can also spread very fast into neighboring homes and even posing a danger to firefighters who are trying to fight these fires. In fact, we're told two firefighters were injured in last night's fire. The fire chief says the ceiling collapsed on one and another injured his knee. Both have already been treated and released. The fire chief says while they're prepared to fight these fires, he says responding to all these vacant house fires certainly has put a strain on their resources.
And it does deplete the resources, but you know, we have a well-protected city, and you know, and it's when those fires become numerous and occur simultaneous that it begins to be a problem.
And in those scenarios, he says they would simply call for help from another fire department in the area. And as for the exact cause of this fire, the chief tells us it's still unknown at this time. Back to you in the studio.
All right, thank you, Diane. The Red Cross tells us they are helping two adults and five children who were affected by the fire last night. Today, the interim tag was removed from Chief Paul Berardi's title. City Manager Troy Schulte says Berardi was chosen after a national search. He takes over for Smokey Dyer, who retired last July. Berardi has been with the Kansas City Fire Department for more than 26 years.